static and dynamic hooks in ZXDC and CXDC. Hi, I'm Becca Cole, media developer at ColeSoft Marketing. This series of videos is designed to help you learn more about CXDC, a new component feature of ZXDC available with release Z2.2 that allows you to test your XLC, C++, and MetalC programs. In this video, we'll talk about static and dynamic hooks. Hooks are used similarly in ZXDC and CXDC, but a new form of static hook has been added for CXDC. Keep an eye out for the help headings listed on the left-hand side of the screen so you can reference topics in greater depth later on in the built-in help or the PDFs on our website. Also remember that you can pause this video at any time if I move through topics too quickly. Let's get started. In order to understand what hooks do, you have to understand a little bit about what ZXDC is and how it works. ZXDC is an ABAND handler, known more formally as a recovery routine. It can run as an ESTA type routine or as an FRR. For C debugging, ZXDC almost always runs as an ESTA X. Because ZXDC is a recovery routine, it can be used in a very large number of ZOS execution environments. However, also because it is a recovery routine, its usefulness can be defeated by the existence of other recovery routines that may have been more recently created by the program or system service routine or exit routine that you want to debug. In order for ZXDC to be effective, it must always be the newest recovery routine for the code that is being debugged. This is where hook comes in. If, for example, LE has issued its own ESTAX for the local code, then a hook will need to be set following that ESTAX in order to make ZXDC the newest recovery routine again. The hook command inserts a ZXDC debugging session into code where a session does not already exist or where ZXDC is not the newest recovery routine. We'll talk more about how this happens in a moment. Occasionally, there is confusion about the difference between hooks and traps. Hooks are used for inserting a debugging session into code where one does not already exist. Traps, which we discussed in an earlier video, are used to capture execution after a debugging session is already in place. There are two types of hooks. A dynamic hook is one that is created on the fly from a currently running debugging session by ZXDC's hook command. Dynamic hooks are designed to create or re-establish debugging sessions without altering any user program register or state attribute, A-mode, ASC mode, cross-memory status, etc. A static hook is a hook that is created at program assembly time. It is a permanent part of the program and cannot be removed during debugging. Hook and hdeferred are both dynamic hook commands. These two commands can be used to set dynamic hooks into many kinds of programs running under many tasks or SRBs in any address space, as permitted by system security. We'll talk about the differences between hook and hdeferred in a moment. For C programs, dynamic hooks will predominantly be used in a multi-module or multi-tasking program when you are debugging a program in one task and want to move to a program in another task. Placing a hook in the next module or task will ensure that ZXDC remains the most recent recovery routine for that module or task. A dynamic hook can be inserted at nearly any point of a program's code. When the hook is reached by program execution, special logic is executed that removes the hook by restoring the program's original code to the hooked location, adjusts the program's PSW so that the restored code will be executed, issues an ESTAX or set FRR macro that makes ZXDC the newest recovery routine for the hooked environment, detects whether or not an ESPY exists that intercepts program checks 1 through 7, ABENs OC1 through OC7, and passes control to ZXDC so that it can display the intercepted program and process your commands. If an ESPY is found during the detection stage, then an ESPY reset is issued to delete the ESPY entirely. The hook command is used to place a hook into code that already resides in storage. It can be used to create a ZXDC debugging session in any execution thread running in the current or any other address space in the system, security permitting. It can be set into pretty much any kind of code there is. The syntax of the hook command is hook followed by an address expression. If set qualifier has been issued, offsets and line numbers can be used as address expressions in place of a full address. This will place a hook at the specified location. The K shortcut command is another method of inserting a hook. It can be typed into the shortcut entry fields of display lines generated mainly by the various storage display commands to place a hook at the displayed storage location. Once a hook is placed, a go command will allow execution to run to the hook point without you having to step execution down the entire code path from here to there. Notice that hook 2 is now gone. Upon being reached by execution, dynamic hooks are always removed before anything else is decided or done. When the hook command creates a hook, it assigns a name in the form hook NNNN, which can be used in other ZXDC commands to reference the hook's location in address expressions. Hook names can also be displayed with the list hooks command, which displays information about active dynamic hooks created by the hook command issued during the current debugging session. Hooks can continue to exist past the end of the current debugging session. In fact, they will continue to exist for as long as the targeted code remains in storage and unexecuted. For simplicity, we are placing our hook in common storage to ensure it remains in place. But a hook's name remains assigned to the hook only during the life of the current debugging session. When that debugging session ends, a surviving hook becomes unnamed. Because the list hooks command can only display hooks created in the current debugging session, ZXDC cannot tell you where hooks from other sessions are located. If you want to display a surviving hook, you will have to know its address. The hdeferred command is used to create deferred hooks. A deferred hook is one that is not yet set, but will be set sometime in the future. Deferred hooks are targeted towards load modules that are not yet resident in storage. They will not be set until the targeted load module is loaded into private storage by link, load, attach, or XCTL. Deferred hooks are not displayed by the list hooks command. To display information about deferred hooks, use the list breakpoints command. The syntax of the hdeferred command is hdeferred followed by an address expression. Address expression is a required parameter. You may specify multiple address expressions separated by commas or blanks. The base of the expression must be the name of a load module, primary or alias. It may not be a register, a PSW, an equate or desect name, or any field name. The named module either may or may not already be loaded into storage. Note, however, that the hook will not be set into any currently loaded copies of the module. You will have to use the hook command for that. If a module map of the load module has previously been loaded via either the map or dmap command, then the given load module name may be further qualified by a csect name. If the given load module name is not qualified by a csect name, then the name refers to the module's entry point address, not its first byte of storage or its load point. If you wish to refer to a module's load point, then qualify the module's name with .x#1. This is useful if the module's entry point address is different from its load point. The address expression may also be modified by offset values. Both positive and negative offsets are permitted. After a deferred hook is created, then when its target module is brought into storage, an active copy of the deferred hook is set into the module at the designated offset. All of the deferred hook's attributes are copied when creating the active hook. Deferred hook definitions are effective only for future loadings of the module that actually cause new copies of the module to be brought into storage. For reentrant programs, if a copy is already in storage, then load will cause that existing copy to be used, so a new hook will not be set. For non-reentrant programs, each load causes a new copy to be brought into storage, so new hooks will be set. The delete hooks command can be used to remove dynamic hooks and to restore original program code to the hook location. Dynamic hooks can be removed regardless of whether they were created by the current debugging session or by a different or prior debugging session. However, because the list hooks command can only display hooks created in the current debugging session, ZXDC cannot tell you where hooks from other sessions are located. If you need to delete a dynamic hook that was created by another debugging session, you're going to have to know where that hook is located. The delete hooks command accepts multiple address expressions for deleting multiple hooks. If no address expressions are given, then all dynamic hooks created by the current debugging session and displayable by the list hooks command are removed. The off command, which we discussed more in our video on CXDC commands, can also be used to remove hooks. When targeting hooks, off functions like a delete hook command. Similarly, the O shortcut command can be used on display lines that show either hooks or traps. When used to remove hooks, it behaves like the delete hooks command. All of the hook commands discussed so far are the same whether you're using ZXDC or CXDC. With CXDC, however, one additional tool has been provided that allows you to include a static hook in your program. CXDC hook is a function that compiles a static hook into your C program. It invokes the XDC hook macro, which creates a debugging session and then passes control to CXDC. CXDC hook is essential if you're running your program in the batch and not under XDC call. If you're running in TSO, XDC call automatically inserts a hook in your program during the auto step process, and CXDC hook is not needed. In order to call CXDC hook, you need to make two changes to your C program's source. You need to include the CXDCHook.h header file into your program. The statement shown here will do the trick. Then, at the point in your code where you want to start a debugging session, you need to call CXDC hook. When execution passes to the CXDC hook function, a CXDC debugging session will be started. Use the statement CXDC hook XDC, where XDC is the name of your CXDC clone. If, for example, you are using a clone of XDC named Z22, then the statement you need to use is CXDC hook Z22. You also need to add an lsearch option to the C compiler to provide the location of the CXDCHook.h header file. The CXDC hook function's code is contained in a load module named AXDC hook. In order for the binder to find the AXDC hook load module, you need to add an include statement to the binder's syslin input file. The library containing the AXDC hook module also needs to be specified on the syslib concatenation. Now you know the basics of static and dynamic hooks in CXDC. You can always find more details in our help documentation. Our next video will talk about mapping in CXDC. If you have any comments or questions about this video or about anything else having to do with ZXDC or CXDC, feel free to contact our staff directly. We can be reached at techsupport@colesoft.com or by phone at 540-456-6164. You can also find more information on our website, www.colesoft.com, or in our LinkedIn users group, www.xdc.com. Thanks for watching.